It's a simple power supply that just works, fully modular, very energy efficient. Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today in this video, I'm going to be checking out the Cooler Master V650 SFX Gold Fully Modular Power Supply. I did receive this product to review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this product, you want to find out more about it, the link to it will be in the video description. You can see the nice retail box and packaging right here walking us through some of the key details about this power supply. It features a 10-year warranty, 100% Japanese capacitors. It's 80 plus gold for energy efficiency, and it's an SFX power supply, so that's going to be great for those smaller form factor builds if you're doing a mini ITX build or anything along those lines. It also comes with an SFX to ATX bracket as well. Now let's go ahead, let's open it up and look at the contents. Here are all the package contents. First up, you can see we have our user guide and manual right here, complete with our pin layout connectors, so you can reference that as needed, and we can expand this out so we can learn more about the power supply. So multiple languages going over all the important information for you. Next up, you can see the bracket we have with the Cooler Master logo and branding, followed by all of our different power cable options right here. So check that out. A couple different screw mount options. We have some different cable ties, whether we want to use Velcro or zip ties. And last but not least, we have the PSU right here. So check it out. Cooler Master logo and branding. Look at how small and compact this is. This is a fully modular 650 watt power supply. You can see Cooler Master V650 on the side. Looks great. Love the design. Here it is from the backside. This is fully modular. So check it out. Everything that we have here that we can connect up to it. Here it is from the other side. Then we can learn more about the tech specs for this specific model. 80 plus gold certified for our power efficiency. Then on this side, you can see our toggle switch. We have our power plug and a note that says fan will not spin until specific core temperature is reached. So keep that in mind. If the fan isn't spinning, that's okay. It's not broken. It will only start to spin when a specific core temperature has been reached. So check that out. Everything looks great, small and compact, beautiful finish. Love the look and feel and design of this power supply. Now let's go ahead, let's get it installed. To get our power supply unit installed for this particular case, we had to attach a bracket to it that mounts to the backside of our case. So you can see we use four of the included screws with the power supply to fit the bracket right on it. And now to finish installation, you can see we're gonna line it right back up here. You can see it's gonna hang down right there, and we're gonna fasten it back with the two screws that came with the case. So here it is, fastened back to the case with the two included screws. And there we go. You can see we have the power supply unit successfully installed. Now we went ahead and connected all the power supply cables that we're gonna need. So you can see we got our main motherboard connector right there and our CPU power as well. Looking at the top of it, you can see how we connected the included power cable in at the top right there. I also went ahead and I tucked in a PCIe cable down here for future reference in case we ever wanna add a GPU, since this build is gonna be using an integrated GPU. I tend to lose cables and misplace them, so it's nice just to sneak it right in there and nobody will notice. Now that our motherboard's installed, we're ready to connect all of our power supply cables. So first up, you can see we have our CPU cable right here. We're gonna run that right through and it's gonna get plugged in right up here in the top left-hand corner. Then our last power supply cable we're gonna connect is our main motherboard cable. And this is gonna drop down right in here so you can see where that is going to be connected. So it's just gonna drop and snap in place right there. So now you can see what it looks like with both of those cables connected. So here's a look at the final build. Overall, very impressed with this power supply. It's a simple power supply that just works, fully modular, very energy efficient. And in our case with 650 watts, we have plenty of additional headroom for future expansion. Well, that concludes our video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget the product link will be in our video description below. Please go ahead, check it out and do your shopping from there. Any purchase made through that link helps support our channel at no additional cost to you. So we're really grateful and thankful for all of your support. While you're at it, can you go ahead and hit that like button for us? And subscribe to our channel. We have new content coming out daily and we don't want you to miss anything. Please go ahead and give us a follow online and make it a clean sweep. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Discord. You can message us on WeChat, check out our website, and join our free newsletter. Thank you guys so much for being here. Don't forget new content daily, and we can't wait to see you in our next video.